Dear students, let us continue with the Unix files. So we were discussing the temporary files. So temporary, it contains temporary files which gets created during the execution of or any operations in the system. So it contains temporary files and all files are deleted periodically. So the disk does not get filled with temporary files. The life of this is set by system administrator. And so these are the temporary files at a fixed period of time. All these files will be deleted from the system so that it doesn't fill the disk. So the what time those temporary files need to be deleted, it should be fixed by the system administrator. Now next, etc. So this etc directory, it contains commands and files of system administration. A type user, a typical user, not allowed to use these files and commands. So these commands present in etc directory need to be executed by system administrator only. So files in this directory include login, password and profile. Next one is library directory. So it contains a collection of related files for a given language in a single file called archive. So a collection of related files will be present for a given language in a single file called archive. A typical Unix system contains library for C, C++ and other languages. So the archive file is used by application developed by that language. So some libraries are also stored in user lib and directory. Next one is TMP. It contains temporary files. All files are deleted periodically so the disk does not get filled with temp files as already discussed here. Next, user. It may hold some directory which contains the Unix utility, tools, languages, libraries and manual pages. So two of the most important subdirectories in the directory are bin and lib. So it holds all the user different users which are logged in the Unix information. Next one is var, that is a variable directory. It contains among several other directories such as var, pool, mail directory that receives and holds your incoming mail messages. When you read your mail, it comes from a file in this directory. Once you have read the mail, it is put in a file in your home directory called mbox. Let us study some basic commands like mkdir. So this command is used to create a directory. So for example, directories are created with the mkdir command. For example, like $mkdir patch. So directory, if you type the command mkdir and the directory name patch and then if you hit enter, so you can create a directory called patch. So we can create a number of subdirectories with one mkdir, like here mkdir patch dba talk. So here three directories or subdirectories are created: patch, dbs and documents. Mkdir, we can create a directory tree as follows. So mkdir pis, pis talks, pis data. So here we created a directory, a PIS. Then we created a proc subdirectory in the PIS and data subdirectory is present in the PIS. So another command which is very, very important, that remove directory, rmdir command. It removes the subdirectory. Suppose in the current directory, suppose if you have a subdirectory called pic, you want to remove it, so you can type the command rmdir pic. So rmdir can also delete more than one directory at a time. So as using the mkdir, more than one subdirectory can be created. Using the rmdir, more than one subdirectory can be deleted. Now let us see rmdir, pic data, pic prop, and pic. So first, the files present in the pic subdirectory got deleted, then the directory itself got deleted. Note the mkdir and rmdir commands work only in directories owned by the user. So if you are a super user or present user, then only these directories will be working. A path names. A path name is a sequence of directory names separated by a front slash which identifies the location of a directory. For example, echo $home. So it displays the location of the present user. So like here, home, Kumar. So this is the path name of the echo command it gives. It gives the path or location of the current user. So there are two types of path names, absolute path name and relative path names. Absolute path name, so the sequence of directory names between the top of the tree and the directory of interest. For example, bin, etc, term, min, inf, term information, export, user, home, ad, and export user home, S3910120. So these are the subdirectories and directory. So these are called absolute path. Where which that absolute path means the file name will be given and it will be started with the root directory. Under the root directory, which subdirectories and which directory it is present, entire location will be given. Now suppose a dollar bin day. So it is a since date is present in the bin subdirectory, which is present in the root directory. So this is called entire, starting from the root to the end of the command. So this will give. So these are called the absolute path name. Similarly, we have the relative path name also. So the sequence of directory names below, the directory where you are now to the directory of the interest. Suppose if you are interested in the directory called project 1. So project 1, if you are in S3910120. And suppose for a project 1 is present in S3910120, then you can give like this. If you are in home, then home S3910120 project 1 if you are to user. So suppose you want to change the directory, so cd progs and cat login.sql. So note here both progs and login.sql are presumed to exist in the current subdirectory, current directory. So this is called root directory, this is called the current working directory, different symbol, special directory names are there, and dot dot it symbolizes the parent directory or the previous directory. So suppose if I give pwd, then it will give you the home, Kumar, progs, data, text. Change directory, pwd, home, Kumar, progs, data, cd. Suppose your current directory is home, Kumar. Present working directory is home, Kumar, progs, data, text. So you want to change the directory, you want to go to the parent directory, then you can type the command cd